Hi people, I hope you're all good. August month was full of festivities for us. Krishna Jayanti, Ganesha Habba, Gauri Habba. Yes, I'm so sure that you all would have celebrated all these festivals and are staying happy and safe. Well, for this month's Dandanaka series, I thought I will get a mythology story for you all. So what if Ganesha Habba is over? We still are ready to listen to stories. Yes, so today's story is going to be about the Dhruva grass or the Arugam pull that we offer to Ganesha. When I was looking for stories around Ganesha, this story intrigued me so much, made me very happy because there are not one but many legends associated with this Dhruva grass or the Arugam pull. I thought I will share a few with you all today. Yes? So the place is Kailashamalai where Shiva and his wife Parvati reside. Shambho Shankara, Shiva Shambho Shankara, Shambho Shankara, Shiva Shambho Shankara. Nandi, the Vahana of Shiva, was very happy. What else does he need? Because he was so happy to be standing right next to his Lord Shiva and assisting him in everything that he needs. But that day, Nandi did not expect that it was going to be a little difficult because Shiva called him and said, "My dear Nandi, you know what? My wife Parvati, she is in a mood to play a game of dice with me." Nandi said, "Mahaprabhu, very, very nice. I would be really glad to watch you both play together." "But no, Nandi, we wanted it more interesting. So we thought we'll make it a competition as to see who's going to win the game of dice." Now Nandi knew that things were not happening the way he thought it would happen. "Okay, Prabhu, as you wish, Prabhu. I think it is a brilliant idea," said Nandi. But then Shiva had another thing to say. "We thought it would be really nice if we have a judge who could judge our playing skills and declare who will be the winner of this game of dice." Beautiful, super idea. I'm really glad, you see. And we didn't know who to put as a judge. And then I suggested, "Nandi is there, no? My devotee Nandi, he will be ready to assist us. He will be the right judge. Won't you be our judge, Nandi?" Now Nandi was in a catch-22 situation. If he's going to say yes, then he would not be happy. If he is going to say no, then his master would not be happy. So he reluctantly agreed to whatever has to come that day to him. He said, "As you wish, Mahaprabhu. Is there anything else that I could say? Let's start playing." But in the heart of hearts, Nandi was just praying that nothing should go wrong. But when Parvati and Parameshwara are playing a game of dice, and all the Ganas and Brahma and Vishnu and all the other Devas are standing there to watch the game, don't you think there needs to be some kind of trick being played? Well, Mahashiva probably knew what the trick was. Nandi was not aware. The game of dice was not going the way he had expected. Parvati Devi was getting an upper hand. What to do now? She was rolling the dice and my God, with every roll of a dice, Nandi could see that she was the one who was going to win. But in the heart of hearts, Nandi was feeling very sad that he would have to declare Parvati Devi as a winner against his favorite Lord Shiva. Now it was the time of the last roll of dice. And Shiva looked at Nandi and gave him a smile. Nandi immediately melted and did not care about anything and knew what he had to say. And when the last roll of dice was thrown, Nandi declared Mahashiva, his master, to be the winner. Whereas it was Parvati Devi who was having an upper hand. Parvati grew furious. She got up from the place. She looked at Nandi and she said, "Maybe you are a Parama devotee, Parama Bhakta of my husband, but that does not give you any reason to do a false judgment. I curse that you would be born as a human separated from your master. Now, that is something that Nandi did not expect. He fell at the feet of Parvati Devi and he said, Ma, I will give away something that is really, 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 that means a lot to me. Please do not separate me from my Lord. Please don't do that. Well, Nandi had to take that curse. But then Parvati Devi's heart was not something that was made of stone. She said, all right, what would you like to leave? I would like to leave the most favorite thing of mine. I would like to give away the most favorite thing of mine. I would like to give away grass. I sacrifice the grass. I sacrifice it to your son Ganesha. The moment he said that, Parvati Devi's heart cooled. And they say she relieved Nandi of the curse. But I will have to take you to a different story to understand how this came to place. The whole of heaven was in a fix. There was another asura, like many other asuras. But this guy seemed to be very different. His name was Anal Asura. Anal in Tamil also meant flames and fumes or heat. Why was he called an Analasura? Because every time he opened his eyes, balls of fire came dashing across the enemy and just burning the enemy to ashes. Nobody was able to go near Analasura. And everybody went to Ganesha for help. Ganapati Bappa, Moria, you are the only person. You will have to come and help us, Ganesha. Please, please help us. This guy seems to be invincible. And we did everything in our powers and we are not able to do anything to him. Well, Ganesha, they say, took the form of a little child. And he went and tried to face the asura. The asura kept throwing balls of fire at Ganesha, coming from his eyes. He just spat balls of fire from his eyes. It went everywhere, killing every other thing. And when it was not possible for Ganesha to handle him, finally Ganesha had to take his Vishwarupam. And they say Ganesha killed Analasura. But then the amount of heat that was generated by the balls of the fire that came and hit Ganesha's body was burning. He was not able to take the heat and he was suffering from the heat. Everybody did everything that they could do. Somebody put a foundation of moon on Ganesha. And that's why they say Ganesha was also called as Palachandra. Vishnu gave him his lotus to cool his body. No, it was not possible. Many other Varuna poured water over him, rained water over him, but no, it did not cool. And then Parvati Devi knew what to do. Listening to Parvati Devi's mind voice, they say 88,000 sages, they went to the Bhuloka and got 21 blades of the Dhruva grass or the Arugampul and placed it on Ganesha's head. The moment the Dhruva grass touched Ganesha's head, Ganesha's body cooled down miraculously and he was at peace. So from then on, they say, if Ganesha is worshipped with this Dhruva grass or the Arugampul, then he blesses all his devotees too, because he's cooled down with the help of Dhruva grass. And now, why Dhruva grass? Because Nandi had told that he would give away something as sacrifice to Ganesha to take him away from the curse that he got from Parvati Devi. Now you see the connection between the two stories. That is why they say we give Dhruva grass as we use Dhruva grass as an offering to Ganesha during Ganesha Chaturthi. Now these are two legends that really interested me and I thought I should share this with you all. Well, now there are many other legends too about an apsara, about how the grass is also considered to be Vishnu's hair, or even Bhuma Devi's hair, or even Sita's hair. So that there are different legends to this. Please go and read up on that. But then I would also like to tell you something beautiful about what this Dhruva grass signifies. They say every Hindu household grows this Dhruva grass, and every time you just take the Dhruva grass, the root is such that it would regenerate immediately in the same place. So this Dhruva grass is also associated with regeneration, rebirth, fertility, and it's considered to be very pious. It also has a very high metaphorical value, is what people believe. Not only that, this Dhruva grass's roots are in such a way that it would go any amount deep inside the soil and to find water. So this Dhruva grass also symbolizes a soul's yearning to go and find or connect to the spiritual self. So that is why this Dhruva grass, attracted me so much, and I wanted to find the stories that are associated with this Dhruva grass. Well, I hope you liked these two small stories that I wanted to share with you all in this Dantanaka series, August edition. So I hope you all had a great Ganesha Chaturthi. Please do go and celebrate more, telling more stories. Until then, it's bye-bye from Lavanya Prasad, Telescope. Ta-ta.